working on a 2015, that's 2015, right?
Yep.
2015 Honda Civic SI. It came in because he was driving home and he noticed that his driver's side front caliper got stuck. It literally, you saw a whole bunch of brake dust, and he said it was really hard to move the car. He kept stalling it out. Signs of a stuck caliper or slider. I didn't waste no time. I pretty much ordered front pads and rotors, Akebono, which is OEM, Honda OEM, and caliper for that side.
This is the only man I know that will put on a Pagani racing shirt.
Yeah, because fuck me the motor cars. Let me see.
Oh, God. And then get on the ground.
No, it's because I had spilled oil on it, right? So I couldn't wear it out anymore. So I was like, fuck it, man. I like wearing car shirts when I'm working on cars because my merch guy still ain't getting me a uniform, but that's a different story. So
it took me a long time to learn to get through that darkness.
Why you guys talk shit about me when I'm right here?
Wheels?
Yeah.
GTR right there.
Yeah. Zero. I like them.
Me too, even though I was gonna be like, big me. Pretty much, you're taking the wheel off. He had different lug nuts, 17 mils. Right? Yeah. They were 17 mils.
This angle.
Huh?
You got a lot of chin on this angle.
Yeah. They call me Crimson.
That shit always works.
Take off the actual caliper from the caliper bracket. The caliper bracket bolts are 14s, if I remember correctly. Then you're gonna, if they're really good on there and the brakes are out of metal because you're changing them, you're not gonna be able to just pop the caliper out. You're gonna need to get a some kind of pry bar, pry it out. And then once you take that out, you get an S hook, or if you could finagle, put the caliper somewhere away where it's not gonna drop down, because you don't want the weight of the caliper on the brake line, because that's how you break the brake line. You want to get the bolts to the caliper bracket. The caliper bracket bolts are both 17s. Once you loosen those, you take that out the way. Now all you should have left after you take off the caliper bracket is the rotor.
Oh, you kind of strong there, boy.
Yeah, that's 4 years of putting up with you.
Wait, is that a compliment or? I don't know how to take that.
I've known you for years, so. You zooming in on my ass? You gay.
It's not gay, you just pointing out the facts.
I feel like I'm taking my time, but I'm still ahead of Alex.
He said, I feel like I'm taking my time, but I'm still ahead of Alex. How you feel about that, Alex?
Well, where are you at?
He got the rotor off.
Well, you know what? That's good for him.
Nah, the rotor's still on.
That shit is heavy.
I'm throwing it at you.
So, this is what you want. It doesn't have the bit, but if you get this tool, it comes with different size Phillips and flatheads. This pretty much has a spring tension on it, so when you hit it with a hammer, it shocks the bolt even more. This tool is made literally for that, for those stupid Phillips that they put on the rotors that never want to come off.
Yo. Alex got the new merch on.
Yeah, I'm here for domestic violence. Yes, sir, car.
Bro's looking fire in it.
Alright, my dumbass, there's two bolts.
Yeah, so.
I took out one.
You could be. After I get this one out, I'll be ahead of you, bitch.
Hit the rotor here.
I already did it.
He's like, I get ahead of you and then you can have it.
Hit it like a man.
I already fucked my shit up.
So I'm like, Alex, I don't know how the fuck I'm gonna get this torque converter off. He's like, well, there's a hole on the side of the buck. I said, well, no shit, Alex. I'm like, it's fucking locked. Yo, and Alex started grabbing and said, well, let me in here.
And what happened?
Let me in.
Where the rotors at?
They're in the office.
All right, I'll grab one rotor.
How's your day going?
You know, it's hard being me sometimes. I'm not the best looking. I'm a little ugly.
What?
I went to go to my brother's school today, and he failed in his class.
He's failing?
The person he's working with is just as dumb as him. I
know. Hey, at least he brought your rotor over for you. I know, hurry the fuck up.
You fucking snitch. Shout out to them niggas that bullied me. Look at me now.
Look at me now. Marvel.
Still getting bullied.
So Frankie jinxed it.
I had told him, I was like, yeah, I should be able to get it done tonight because it's just a caliper, brake flush, front pads, and rotors. It was going too well. Alex, you know, I started talking shit to Alex that I was doing it faster than him, then he did his side better. But he didn't have to do a caliper. He only had to do pads and rotors. But thanks to Frankie, he jinxed me. The bleeder was on the bottom, not the top, so that means they sent me a passenger side, not a driver's side. So I had to wait the next morning till like, what? I mean, the next day till like
2 o'clock.
2 o'clock for them to give me the right one. As soon as it was done, I mean, as soon as it got here, it got done like half an hour later. And then we were nice enough to go drop off the car because we were going to McWednesdays and we were going that way anyways, and Frankie was catching a ride with me, so we dropped off the car to him.
You got a hole in your armpit right there.
Here goes. I can't wear my good shirts. Because, again, you can put this in the video for the second time. My merch guy still hasn't got me my shirts, my uniform shirts, so. It is the next day. Fuck you, Alex. That's all I'm gonna say. I don't care if it come with lube, you lube it yourself.
Sliders, always lube these sliders. If they get frozen, I'm gonna hate you.
One sec.
I'm gonna hate you, and whatever tech works on your car is gonna hate you when
they're dry as hell
and you don't lube them, because this is what helps the piston go back.
Yeah,
fuck.
Just hit my camera with his head.
Yep. I sure did.
Have you talked to Tyler?
I texted him last night. While I was there too, I asked him if he did a brake flush on the car. You're supposed to do it every 2 years, 24,000 miles. But he did it, so I recommended that. Those that are not familiar, this is a BG brake flush machine. I did one front caliper, front pads and rotors on this car. Instead of just bleeding the one caliper, I recommended a brake flush where we flush the whole system out with this machine. Most of them come with dot three. Difference between dot three and dot four is dot four has a higher boiling point, so you can get on your brakes more aggressively and not get brake fade. This is pretty self-explanatory. Obviously, you have each caliper. This is for the master cylinder fill. Normally, what I do is I'll suck all the fluid that's in the master reservoir to get all that old fluid out, and then I'll connect and let it pump new fluid in, and then you just go based off this. I can't see the max fill line.
Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, and good. Oh, I took you over.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Awkward.
That's pretty much it. So it sucks all the gunky fluid that's in there. Because normally if you just connect, the last bit of fluid that's already there will be the last fluid that gets flushed. This is just, you kind of beat it into the punch. Tight, so I had to get these stupid teeth to come down enough to kind of click where they need to. And now, click this on. And then I open this valve, and you'll watch as I open the valve, watch the fluid go down. And that's pretty much the filling of the master.
I was trying to get the shot, and this asshole just went and started working.
look at all that fluid. You see it? Get it on camera. Look at all that fluid.
While I'm here, though, let me take a picture and send it to custom.
You got holes on this side, too?
Huh?
You got holes on this side, too?
Yeah, it's cause my shoulder's so big and they're so brolic that it just be... It's a biceps, man. You know what's crazy? If I would've kept this shirt in pristine condition, it'd probably be worse.
Yeah.
This is the new caliper. The one that actually has air in it. So I'm gonna let it go like all the way down and bleed the hell out of it.
I said that shit's sucking more than your ex.
Yeah.
My heart. My heart.
I have a brake flush machine, so I don't need somebody else's help to pump. But if you have a brake flush machine, you know how to use it. In the video, I explain how to use it. I'm gonna explain if you have a friend who's helping you bleed brakes. So normally, you have a buddy. If you wanna bleed all of them, you always start with the caliper farthest from the master. All the cars here are left-hand drive, so you always start with the right caliper, right rear. But in this case, let's say you just wanna bleed that one because you're only changing out that one caliper. What you do is you have a buddy sit in the car. They slowly pump the pedal. Don't like mash it. Slowly pump it 5 times until it starts to build pressure. I mean, in a system like this, it's gonna have pressure because you only have air at one of the lines out of the four. So it's gonna, the unexperienced foot won't be able to tell the difference. So you wanna pump 5 times and then hold. And then once you crack the bleeder loose and the person in the car is holding, their foot is on the pedal, you want to tell them to push all the way down because that helps all the air come out even more, and then hold it down until you close the bleeder again. And you want to keep doing that until you see a steady stream coming out of the bleeder hole, and at that point the pedal should feel pretty much normal.